In any event, Justin, you and I were out at Lewis Snyder, the supposed big game of the week.
Yeah.
It was right up until the point where Lewis lost like the entire starting offense.
Yeah.
I mean, they were down 5 starters to start the game. They lost defensive lineman Elijah Jett. He was out with a concussion. Jalen Charlton was limited to defense because of an ankle problem he suffered last week.
Starting running back.
He was limited to defense, and he was hobbled because of his ankle. Quarterback Noah Wyszynski didn't even play because of a foot injury. His foot was in a boot. He's on the sideline. Oh, by the way, their Ohio State commit, he is the most explosive athlete in the city this year. Austin Mack, he goes out after 12 minutes of playing with a concussion, ends up getting carted off, taken to the hospital. Having said that, Lewis was pretty valiant in their effort.
You know, they were. And, you know, before Mack went out, we watched the second play from scrimmage. They're running the Wildcat. And Coach Lindsey said, you know, we split the snaps in practice between Jack Johnston and Austin Mack. Their goal was to get the ball into the hands of Mack as much time as possible. I think of the first 7 snaps, he touched the ball at least 6 of them.
Right.
So it was.
Seems pretty smart.
Yeah. Snap to Mack, hand off to Mack, you know, throw to Mack. I mean, that's what it was. And it was, it's what they had to do to win that game.
Right.
And then when he goes out, not only did it completely derail the offense, which I thought the offense did a good job even without him. They surprised me.
Right.
But the defense, losing Mack on defense was huge.
It takes away that entire side of the field. When he's in the game, you can't throw to that side of the field wherever he's lined up. And but we saw Snyder receivers wide open. I mean, by 10 yards.
Yeah, I mean, those guys are tough to defend anyway, but I mean, the secondary was just completely out of position. The one time they scored when Malik Bramley, the 53-yard touchdown reception early in the second quarter, they did a play action, and there were 2 guys streaking down the field. Stiebling just had to pick one of them and throw it up because they had 2 guys at least 5 yards behind the defense.
Yeah.
It was tough.
Isaac Stiebling was playing pitch and catch tonight. It was basically, where do I want to go? Okay, I'll go there. And he barely broke a sweat, but he was very, very statistically
Good. 18 to 21, 298 for 4 touchdowns. Also ran for another touchdown.
Yeah, I don't know what that quarterback rating is, but it's freaking high. So Isaac Stiebling did really well tonight. Snyder looked like the behemoth powerhouse that they are. I can't wait for the Snyder-Carroll matchup to be
that, to me, at this point, looks like the SAC championship game to me. And you saw Homestead tonight, so you have a good reference on them. But just the way Snyder can score points.
Yeah.
I just don't know if anybody can keep up. And that game could be, you know, 60 to 58. I don't know. I mean, that's going to be crazy. But you saw Homestead tonight, and they seem pretty good.
And I think Homestead offensively will be able to compete with anybody in the SAC. I don't know where their defense is. It's hard to tell at this point. Northside definitely has some athletes and some really strong, obviously, you know, Nevis is a strong quarterback, so they've got good quarterback play. But Homestead, they're putting up the video game numbers tonight. Kazai, is that how you say it?
Yeah, Drew Kazai.
17-24, 360 yards, 5 touchdowns.
That's not bad. Remember we were talking in the preseason, we were like, well, who's going to be the Homestead quarterback? I mean, they got 2 guys.
Yeah.
But Homestead always has a quarterback, you know?
And the thing is, we knew about Skronik and how good he is. 5 catches, 115 yards, 3 touchdowns. Austin Kreider, who's really battled ankle problems the last 2 years, been a really good quality receiver for him, but he's been banged up a little bit. He's not banged up anymore. 9 catches, 169 yards, 2 touchdowns. And then you throw in Landon Durnell, the running back, who I wrote a little bit about in my column for Saturday, is 12 carries, 108 yards, and really had a big run that set up their final score in the first half that kind of turned the game. They call him the machine.
So. Okay, that works. Well, it's interesting because Kyle Lindsey referred to Snyder as a machine tonight. So
I think there are a lot of machines,
there's a lot of machines
offensively in the SAC this year.
I think after 2 weeks we're starting to get a little bit of clarity to the SAC in that you've got the elite teams, the Snyders, the Homesteads, the Carrolls. Then you've got maybe the next tier, Dwinger maybe might be in that next tier.
I think North could be. I mean, I see a lot of potential.
Lures, obviously. Yeah.
The key with like a North side is they got to go to Carroll next week, okay? Very similar. It's like Homestead on steroids a little bit, okay?
Right.
So they could very well get smashed again next week.
Right.
But how do they respond? Is it 1-2 and all of a sudden they go here and go again? Because last year Coach Hall said the problem with that team was they get 1-2 and then it just starts steamrolling.
Right.
You know, I mean, you get down and you get thumped this week and you go next week and then you got to pick yourself back up.
There's some big time passing attacks that you've had around here.
I know.
Yeah, there are.
And I know coaches are like, well, we don't want to get in shootouts, but I mean, every
there's
game.
No way.
I mean, to win a game in this conference, you are going to have to score 30 points.
Northside could score. They're really. I was impressed by David Johnson, their receiver, just so fast. He was getting behind a Homestead secondary and great hands. So I like Northside too, even though they got thumped pretty good tonight.
Northrop got a nice win over Wayne, and I was told at the Snyder game that Austin Robertson for Wayne didn't play tonight. So that probably hurt them to a degree. I don't know if he would have made a difference.
Maybe they lose by, 25 instead of 35 or whatever.
Yeah,
it was,
whatever.
So.
But Northrop got a nice win, but it looks like Wayne and Southside are going to be those bottom tier teams.
I think they play next week.
Do they?
I believe. I mean, that's
a competitive game.
At this point,
game.
I'm picking South in that game.
Yeah.
Just because.
Wayne
has to score to win. They haven't scored a point yet. So,
right, yeah.
You do have to score to win.
Dynamite analysis.
You don't get that
here.
Analysis anywhere else.
I'm out of here.
Speaking of explosive offenses, New Haven, they can score some points.
Yeah.
And again, this week, they blew up on Lakeland tonight. And they drop tonight?
Like 53?
Like 63,
I think.
Was it 63?
So. Maybe it was 53. I don't know. It was up there.
Yeah. So New Haven looks like they might be the class of the NEA.
Although Leo tonight, they just destroyed Angola, which I thought at least that would be close for a while, but they just came out and, so maybe we're looking at
I don't know. I don't know if you can – I mean, New Haven's good, but I don't know how good Lakeland defensively is. I imagine that speed and quickness just did them in as New Haven did to Heritage week before.
Well, next week's games, as we look ahead, Homestead is playing
Dwinger,
which Dwinger's really bounced back this week with a nice offensive performance. Ironically, their quarterback statistically didn't play very well tonight, but their offense scored a lot of points tonight. So that looks like a really good game next week. Woodland and Heritage is an interesting game. Very comparable to this week when we talked about DeKalb and Garrett, we thought that would be a competitive game, and it was.
Yeah.
Garrett ended up getting a really nice win over a big school like DeKalb. So good win for the Railroaders. But Woodland Heritage next week, that's an interesting matchup, I believe.
Yeah, I'm just not sure, and you may know a little more about Heritage. I just don't know if they are going to be able to slow down Woodland enough. To be, I mean, because Heritage, they lost so much, the graduation. They got Justin Hart, but other than that, I mean,
they're rebuilding. I mean, they scored 12 points against Norwell tonight, but one of those was a pick six, so it's not like their offense is putting up points. And Norwell's rebuilding this year as well, so I don't know if Heritage can handle
that's
Woodland.
I mean, I think Woodland may be the only team that can. Maybe run away with the ACC this year. I mean, Adams Central, though, 2-0, maybe that'll be a sneaky good team to, they go on the road and get a big win tonight. So maybe they're the team that can give Woodland a shot. So.
Well, I will say this. It's way, way, way too early to talk about player of the year, New Sentinel player of the year. But who's a player that's jumped out to you this year?
I thought
after
you said that's way
weeks?
Too early.
I always like to talk about
as we
that.
Have teams.
I really thought Stiebling looked really good tonight.
Yeah,
he's a dual threat guy.
Yeah, but we never saw him under pressure and under duress.
That's
true. How does he handle it when somebody's in his face? I'm sure he can handle it pretty well. He's a Division I quarterback. But, I mean, things were very, very easy tonight for him.
But
it was almost pitching catch.
I can't wait to watch him and Aiden Smith go out.
That's
going to
be crazy. That's going to be really crazy. And, I mean, you saw Nishan Jones,
right.
I mean, he's phenomenal.
Tyon Woods from New Haven.
Yeah, Ty Woods is
a money kid for Snyder.
Money Woods.
Money Woods.
He's gonna, you can pick good. Any of those three
he's money.
Receivers and, you know, for Snyder.
Skronik is super talented. I mean,
he had five catches tonight and three touchdowns.
Yeah.
That's not bad. That's a good ratio.
That is not bad.
When 60% of your receptions go for touchdowns, that's good.
That is pretty good. And the thing about him that he runs in stride, catches those balls. You know, a lot of guys you'll see adjusting going this. I mean, he just counts on the quarterback, and he's putting it there, putting it to him. So there's a lot of great players around right now.
There are. There's some good football this year. This is turning into a really, really good year. And
good offensive football. We'd love to see that sack.
I don't
want
just,
defense. I only like offense.
Well, then you'll like it. Well, no, I don't want to say you'll like the sack, because there's some good defense. It's just a matter you can't, like, you know, Snyder is a good defensive team, but Lures at times early on, I mean, until 5 minutes to go in the third quarter, it was a tie game.
Yeah, you know, you look at Lures and you look at the score, you say 55-27, but, you're without your quarterback with Wyszynski. You're without for three-fourths of the game, at least, without Mack.
Right.
You're missing your best defensive lineman in Elijah Jett.
Yeah.
You can't play Jalen Charlton on offense. He's your best running back.
You know what? Kyle Lindsey talked after the game about what a mistake it was to throw the ball with a minute plus.
Oh yeah, that was second quarter. Because
and
you're
Snyder,
sitting there, you're up 27-20.
Right.
You're up 27.
No, it was 2014.
It was 2014.
It was 2014, well, they had a pick six, and so they tied it.
Well, they didn't have a pick six; they took it down to the seven.
Yeah,
but
then they scored.
They missed the extra point, but yeah, you're right, because it was 2014. Then Lures forces Snyder to punt.
Right.
About a minute and a half left in the half.
If you just go into the locker room, you feel good about
yourself.
But
you know, it's easy to second guess. But you're sitting there. We have the momentum. My gosh, if we score another touchdown before half, we're up two scores going into the break. I mean, it's tough to. In hindsight, it looks bad. But you know, maybe with a Wyszynski, you feel more comfortable doing that. Maybe you kind of got a little ahead of yourself with Jack Johnson, who I thought played pretty well. But yeah, that was the big momentum switcher, because Snyder goes into halftime with the momentum.
Right.
And it's tied, as opposed to Lures gets into the second half.
Yeah, and they just wore down. I mean, Lures did what they could.
It's no excuse. I mean, it's just, you know, what Coach Lindsey said. He said, other than our offensive line, everybody was going both ways tonight.
Right.
I mean, Jack Johnston sticks somebody and blows up off screen. He had to play linebacker tonight.
Right, and quarterback.
Yeah, and quarterback. So
it'll be interesting to see, as the weather changes and everything else, if that offensive football starts to come back to the
years past, I've seen Homestead look great in September, not so great in late October. Right. So
and
that's it. I think that's true of a lot of passing oriented offenses when you get later in the year. So.
Hey, by the way, good win for East Noble tonight. They were in a dogfight with Warsaw, but then they ended up pulling away late, and I think they won by two scores.
Andrew McCormick, 497 total yards tonight.
Was he?
He had a
pretty good
throwing touchdown.
He's a sophomore.
He had two rushing touchdowns, had a receiving touchdown.
Aren't they playing Leo pretty soon? They play this week?
So.
I don't think they play next week.
It's pretty soon in this, early
year. Yeah, because I think they play New Haven week 8, I think, but they play Leo here soon enough, next week or the week after. But
that'd be good.
I think, looking it up, Snyder, first two games, they score 49 or more points. Last time they did that was 2004. Went to the state championship game, 14-1. Lost to Warren Central in the championship game under Coach Russ Isaac. So,
you know, Carroll has potential to go deep in the tournament. Lures has potential to go deep in the tournament.
Carroll's got to run up against Carmel.
Yeah, that's
brutal. They need to kick a couple kids out of 100 kids out of school. They could drop
100, like 1500 or whatever.
Whatever you gotta do, start the freshman academy.
Yeah. By the way, right now it's about 12:17. I'm getting loopy because I'm tired, and our night's like not even close to being over. But go to newsentinel.com first thing in the morning. Brent Glasgow's down in Indianapolis, covered the matchup between Ben Davis and Avon tonight. Ben Davis ended up winning that, if I remember correctly. But Brent's got a feature on a couple of Michigan recruits, and we'll tell you all about how they did. So we've got Indianapolis covered, Northeast Indiana covered. Reggie, you got anything on the Colts tomorrow?
There's a little bit of Colts action.
A little bit of Colts, okay.
Yeah, and they play St. Louis tomorrow night.
Oh, that's right, at St. Louis.
Yep.
maybe the last time that they have to go to St. Louis, because the Rams may end up back in L.A. You never know.
Here's an interesting thing, too, is about, you know, Carroll and Homestead, and they come in and everybody's kind of, we're going to show them kind of thing. They're 4-0, averaging 52 points a game. Now, they haven't played Snyder or Dwanger or Lewis or anybody like that, but they play Concordia and Northside. And those, you know, there were people on every SAC team that were kind of saying, wait till they get to the SAC. Right. Here they are.
And they're doing well.
Yeah, they're not struggling yet, you know. And, and you know, I guess we'll have to wait till see they play Snyder and Lures. But so far, so good for Homestead and Carroll.
I think Homestead and Carroll will be able to score points against Snyder and against you know, if they can score against Northside they're fine.
Yeah, so. I do think maybe Snyder's coverage will be a little bit better deep. I think Northside just, you know,
Carroll hadn't played anybody. I mean, hadn't had a tough test in Northrop.
If anybody gets to ease into their schedule, it's Carroll, because you know you start with Northrop and South, and then you get Northside, and then it starts picking up. I mean, it looks good in that front half, but the back end is just going to be murder. Yeah.
But Coach Dinan is an SAC guy, so he knows what that football's like. He knows how to prepare his team. Carroll will be fine.
Yeah, I think so. I think so, too. So
all right. Well, hey, follow us all on Twitter and go to newsentinel.com. We got, I mean, I could sit here and list all the different components to our prep football coverage that we'll have by first thing in the morning. But it'll be first thing in the morning by the time I finish. So
Stuff will trickle online here in the next hour or two. So
we've got columns, we've got features, we've got a photo gallery.
Power poll.
We got a lot, and I want to get to bed like before 4. So I do appreciate you guys watching this, though. And we got players of the week also.
Yeah, players of the night. We'll come up with 5 of them, and it'll be online voting starting early morning.
Narrow it to 5.
We'll try to narrow it down. I think Andrew McCormick is going to be on there. I think Isaac Stiebling is going to be on there. Well, there's a couple of safe picks for right now, so we'll see who else.
But you will actually determine who gets that award. You can vote all weekend long, all the way through Monday. And Monday at midnight, we cut it off, and we announce the winner in Tuesday's edition. So, all right. Thanks for joining us. Appreciate it.